four-story beam. A four-story reinforced concrete office building. This is the elevation. In first floor, you have a height of 4.2 meter. And rest of the floors are having 3.2 meter. It's 3200 mm and 4200 mm. This is in terms of mm. And you can see a difference of height. Okay. Now, if we are looking into this plan, this is a simple rectangular building. This has a good configuration, and you can see that what are the acceptable configuration is circle, rectangle, square. If you have shapes like this, then it will perform well during the earthquake. So here you can see those kind of structure. And what is the distance between two columns is 4 at 5000. That means you have four number of bays, 1, 2, 3, 4. So each bay carries 5000 mm, that is 5 meter. So total, what is the distance? 20 meter of dimension. And at other side, you have 3 into 5000, that is 15,000 mm. It will be 15 meter. The thing is located in Shillong, seismic zone 5. Here they have given the zone in this problem. So you don't need to refer the annex E. The zone is given, only the value of zone 5 has to be referred. The soil condition are medium stiff, and the entire building is supported on raft foundation. The overall built up area will be covered with a single foundation. For all the columns, you have a uniform foundation called raft foundation. The RC frames are infilled with brick masonry, but here you have RC infills. Here the RC frames are infilled with brick masonry. The lumped weight due to dead loads are 12 kN per meter square and floor on floor, and 10 kN per meter square on roof. So how many floors are available? 1, 2, 3. So 3 number of individual floor and 1 roof. The last floor is known to be as roof. Rest of the floors are having a dead load of 12. The roof is having a dead load of 10. The floors are to cater a live load of 4 kN per meter square on floors and 1.5 kN per meter square on roof. So instead of live load, they have given in terms of kN per meter square. So what is the dimension of the building? 20 meter into 15 meter. So each bay carries 5 meter. 5, 10, 15, 20. So 20 meter by 5, 10, 15. So 300. So 300 is the overall area. If you multiply by live load, 300 into 4 will be 1200 kilonewton at the floor. Live load on a single floor is 1200 kilonewton. This is dead load. And 1200 plus, you can add the dead load here. The way you can multiply, determine the design seismic load on the structure as per new code. So this is a moment resting frame, and detailing is done by 13920, is known to be a special moment resting frame. If any frame is detailed as per 13920, then it is called what frame? Special moment resting frame. Okay. So with this data, you have to find the seismic load in each floor. Up to 15 meter height, you can use equivalent static load. What is the height of the building? This is 4.2, 3.2, 3.2, 3.2. What is total height? 13.8. So if it is below 15 meter, you can use equivalent static load. Here they have only said that determine the seismic load on a structure as per new code. They have not said what technique. So if it is less than 15 meter, you have to identify that this can be solved by equivalent static load. Find the natural period of a structure. What is the formula for that? 0.09 H by root of D for all other buildings. Do you have this case? Check in code book 7.6.2, bare moment resting frame without any masonry infill. Do we have any infill our structure? Yes, we have. So you should not use this. And building with RC structural wall, this formula, we are not having RC structural wall. We only have masonry bricks. What is the given data? Bricks. No, that is masonry bricks only used. So you can use all other buildings. You can find TA. What is your TA? H by root D. What is overall height? 13.8. Root D is, what is the largest dimension? 4 into 5 meter. That is 20. Each bay carries 5 meter. 4 into 5 will be 20 at one direction. If earthquake comes at this direction, what you will do? If you are finding in a single direction, if earthquake comes under this axis, y axis, then it is okay. If earthquake comes under x axis, can come in both the directions. No, the wave can generate at whatever direction. So you can find for both. Fundamental period for x direction and fundamental period for y direction. If your dimensions are same, you can use only one. If your dimensions are unequal, you can find both. T equal to h root d. Now this is for x direction, 13.8 into root 20, 0.28 seconds. Now for y direction, 3 into 5 is 15. So instead of 20, you substitute root 15, 0.32 second. Now first step is over. Step 2, determination of other important factors. What are the factors? AH, horizontal acceleration coefficient. What are the coefficient are there? SA by G, Z, I and R, four parameters. For all the four you have respective tables. First to find SA by G, 6.4.2 section A. This is used for equivalent static method. So your SA by G comes under medium to stiff. What is your value? Time period 0.28. So this comes under first criteria, that is 0 to 0.55. What is the second value? One is 0.2832. So both the natural period comes under first case. So you can take the value as 2.5. SA by G equal to 2.5. Earthquake can come at both the direction, your fundamental natural period doesn't change. Find zone. Shillong coming under zone 5 and 0.36. Importance factor. Okay, what kind of building is this? Office building. Can you find office building here? Either they have given any office building. Office building is a generalized terminology. They have not given specific school or residential building. There are some categories. Categories of structures. They have not said any category. So you can take all other buildings. If they have said as residential or commercial, if they have particularly mentioned these names, you can take it as 1.5. If the name is not available, you can take it as all other buildings as 1. Note, this importance factor, they have given a note. The owners and design engineers of the building or structures may choose the value of importance factor more than those mentioned above. This is not for your exam purpose, this is for your career purpose, I am saying. If you are building, really building a structure, if your owner thinks that, no, my building should be strong, even it should not have any small cracks in my house, if he is thinking, the owner can change the importance factor. The owners and design engineers of the building or structures may choose the value of I. You can choose the value as 1 or 1.5. So the owner cannot choose. If he is standing in 1.5, he cannot reduce to 1. He can only increase for improvement of safety. What does code says is minimum. You should not go beyond this value. That is the thing what you are referring for guideline. Above that you can take as per your economy. So it should not be below that. So the notes are only useful when you are independently doing some civil engineering works. Okay, I is over. Then R, response reduction system. What they have said? A terminology. The building is provided with moment resting frames detailed as per IS 13920. So what do you mean by this? This is not normal moment resting frame, this is special moment resting frame. If your building is only having frames, it is called normal frame. If your building frame is detailed as per 13920, then the same building is called as special moment resting frame building. So even civil engineers have different categories. You can speak with your owner, discuss that you need special building or normal building. He will ask, what is special building? Any special features you are going to give? You have to say that I am going to follow this IS 13920. This I will discuss in module 5. What are the detailing to make your building special? All the parameters are known. What is step 3? Determination of design horizontal seismic coefficient, AH. You will be getting substituting all these values, 0.09. This doesn't have any unit. Determination of seismic weight, floor area, 15 meter at one side and other side is 20 meter. You have 15 meter at one side and 20 meter at other side. Multiply, you will be getting total area into the dead load, into the live load. The floor area is 300 square meter. And if you multiply into 4, you will be getting 1200. Only 50% of live load is lumped at the floor. At roof, no live load will be there. Only consider 50% of this. In code book, they have mentioned 50% of live load. If your live load is more than 3 kN per meter, so what is your live load? 4 kN. If it is more than 3, you have to reduce 50%. The weight is being found out like this, 0.5 × 4. 0.5 × 4 plus 12. What is this 12? Dead load, isn't it? 12. So this is dead load and live load. If you combine, you will be getting total load. Combining this and multiplying by area, you will get weight on the three floors. What are they? W1, W2, W3. What is the fourth floor? That is roof. Roof doesn't have any live load. It only has the dead load. Dead load is 10. 300 into 10 is 3000. So your total weight will be 4200 into 3 plus 3000. Totally 15,000 kN. To know the AH into 15,600 kN. So VB can be found out by AHW. Multiply, you will be getting 1400 kN as your base here. So earthquake is creating 1400 kN and it is pushing the building. Now you need to find step 6. At first floor, what is the earthquake force? At second floor, what is the earthquake force? So you have to find floor by floor. Like this, you have to draw a picture. For all the buildings, earthquake force will be less for which floor? Ground floor. Check the previous problem and this problem. First floor, see, generally the basement floor will be having zero earthquake force. First floor will be having lesser, that is 77, 239, 491, and last floor. If you are in the top floor or in the roof, you will be experiencing most of the earthquake and the deflection will also be high. So you can find the force for each and every floor by using this equivalent static load method.